of her, let me read it in NIV. When the time of their purification according to the law of Moses had been completed, Joseph and Mary took time, took him, to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. Okay. According to the law of Moses, a woman who had a male child was unclean for 7 days. So in this scripture here, the purification time, according to the law of Moses, it had been completed. So here's Joseph and here's Mary presenting him to Jerusalem, present him to the Lord. 23, as it is written in the law of the Lord, every firstborn male is to be consecrated to the Lord.
Come on.
And to offer a sacrifice in keeping with what is said in the law of the Lord, a pair of doves or two young pigeons. Now, when Mary and Joseph was presenting Jesus Christ, the offering or the sacrifice that they used, the scripture said that it was a pair of doves or a pair of pigeons. That was an indication of their financial stability. Mary and Joseph were not rich. They did not have a lot of money. They were actually poor. So the scripture said that, hey, if you cannot offer a lamb as your sacrificial offering, you can offer a pair of doves or a pair of pigeons. So that's what they did. That's what they offered when they were getting ready to present Jesus Christ, the baby Jesus. How am I doing with time?
Yes.
Okay. Let's go on. In verse 25. Now there was a man in Jerusalem called Simeon, who was righteous and devout. He was waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. Now, this man in Jerusalem called Simeon. Simeon had been told by the Spirit of God that you would not see death. I believe that's all in the next scripture. You would not see death until you see Jesus the Christ. Has God ever made a promise to you? And it has come to fruition. Now, though it may tarry, it will still come. We just talked a few moments ago about season. If you are not ready in the season that you're in for the particular blessing or for whatever God is trying to get to you, God does everything in not your time. He does everything in his time. Sometimes what we want, we cannot handle it in our time or what we want at this certain time. It had been revealed to him. Now the Holy Spirit told Simeon this, that you're not going to die. You're not going to die. Until you see the Christ. So he said, it revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that you would not die before he had seen the Lord's Christ. Moved by the Spirit, he went into the temple. Now, you mean to tell me the Holy Spirit tells Simeon of something about a future event? Okay? Tell Simeon you're not going to die until you see the Christ. Now, let's fast forward. The scripture then said the Holy Spirit moved on Simeon and told Simeon to go to the temple courts. So here is the results or manifestation of something the Holy Spirit said earlier on. Y'all with me? Y'all follow me? So the Holy Spirit said in verse 27, it said, moved by the Spirit, he went into the temple courts. When the parents brought in the child, Jesus to do for him what the custom of the law required, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, this is what Simeon said as he was holding baby Jesus. Sovereign Lord, as you have promised. Sometimes you can remember what God has promised and remind him, not that he forgot, but remind him, God, you said, as you have promised, you now dismiss. Hey, I'm at peace now. I have gotten to see what you promised me earlier on that I would see, the baby Christ. You now dismiss your servant in peace, for my eyes have seen your salvation. I have seen your glory. I have seen the Christ. So now, I can go on and depart and be with you. This is Simeon. We prepare in the sight of all people a light of revelation to the Gentiles and for glory to your people. The Bible says that, and I don't know if I skipped the verse, I just remember it. The Bible says that Simeon was a devout, I don't think I read it, but I remember reading it earlier. A devout and, it was another word they described.
Yes.
Check this out. And then I'm gonna sit down. Check this out. When we talk about a just man, just in his dealings, just in his dealings with other men, with toward other people. But when we talk about a devout man, just in how he is with God, just in his dealings with the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, or devout, I should say, in his dealings with the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So the Bible says that the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. That's what it says. And he delighteth in his way. It would suffice to say that Simeon was a good man. The Bible says he was a devout and he was just. So his steps was being ordered by the Lord. Simeon, you will see the Christ. Now, Simeon, if I did further research, I probably could have found out how old Simeon was. He was old, I know he was old, but I probably could find exactly how old he was. But he didn't lose sight of the promise. Sometimes we can lose sight and be like, okay, well, God, you said you were, hey, look at Sarah. Look at Sarah. How old was Sarah? We can't afford to lose. If God gave you a promise, if God said he was going to do something on your behalf, it doesn't matter if you're 110 years old. You cannot die until you see what he has promised you.
Come on. Yeah.
You will not die